Good morning, sir.
Morning.
Today, I would like to raise the question of one of the most burning issues of our state, that is the Citizenship Amendment Bill. This bill has been a great threat to the indigenous people of Manipur. And because of this, many efforts, such as scheduled tribe demand, has been undertaken. ILP is also closely linked to it. And the Manipur People Bill that was sent to Honorable President of India that had not been passed, these are all linked together. My question for you is, what are your views for this? How are you going to protect integrity? How are you going to protect the existence of the indigenous people? And also another thing that I want to ask you is about corruption. So as we all know that corruption is widespread in our country, it is quite uncommon for us to not even get a job without paying a bribe or something like that. It is a huge harm for us youth because we are afraid of getting unemployed in the future, even after we have completed many degrees. So my question is, sir, how are you going to solve this problem? What steps are you going to take to ensure our safety, insurance and all? Thank you, sir.
So on the Citizen Amendment Bill, I'm very clear. It is, again, cultural imperialism. It is an attempt to crush the spirit of the Northeast. And I'm absolutely crystal clear. We fought against the Citizen Amendment Bill in Parliament and we defeated the bill in Parliament. The Congress Party did it. And we are not going to allow this Citizen Amendment Bill to destroy the lives of the Northeast. So we are absolutely crystal clear on that. There is going to be no encroachment in the culture, the language, and the history of the Northeast. We're not going to allow it. And we will fight tooth and nail to ensure that Citizen Amendment Bill does not become law. On your corruption question, number one, the structures that protect us against corruption are the institutions. The Supreme Court, the judicial system, the free press, these institutions. So number one, when we come to power, we are going to stop the attack that Narendra Modi is carrying out on these institutions. We are going to allow these institutions their independence. We will allow the judiciary to be independent. We will allow the Election Commission to function. We will allow courts to opine on things independently. Second, youngsters like you, who are honest, need to come into the political system. You can't complain that politics is not the way I want it, and then keep sitting there and not come into the political system. So we would like as many young, new people, fresh faces, to come into the political system to help us clean the system. Finally, there are laws that you can pass, the right to information, where you allow any citizen to ask any question about his government, ask the bureaucracy any question that they feel they'd like to know. So there are laws that you can pass, and the RTI was a landmark law that we passed. Now that has also been diluted and sort of distorted. So we would like to make those laws more effective as well. Finally, you can't centralize power and expect corruption to reduce. Today what is happening is power is being centralized in the chief minister's office and the prime minister's office. We would like to delegate power down. We would like to delegate power to the panchayats, to the lower levels of government, so that people can access the political system, people can participate in the decisions, people can ask questions, and there can be more transparency. So that would be the broad direction. But frankly, we need your help. You know, we need youngsters to come into the political system to help us clean the political system. It's not going to be possible without you.
The next question is from Shiva Ranjani, MBBS RIMS. She's in the first row. Please give her a mic.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir. Sir, you have frequently addressed GST as Gabbar Singh tax. And, sir, if you come in. Sorry, sir. Come to power in 2019. Scrap up the GST.
The mic is not working. Would we scrap GST? Is that your question? Do you want GST scrapped? Do you want GST scrapped?
I don't want it to be scrapped up, but I want it to be modified. And sir, what would be your tax model if you come to empower them?
Okay. Yeah, thank you. So, the basic idea behind the GST is one tax, simple tax, minimum tax. That is the basic idea. And why I call the current GST Gabbar Singh tax is because it is not actually a GST. It's not a GST. I mean, Mr. Narendra Modi has sold the country something which it isn't. If you ask any economist in the world, is India's GST a GST? He will tell you, no, it's not a GST because the GST cannot have five different taxes. A GST has to have one tax. So I'm glad you've caught on to this. And it is our endeavor when we come to power to give India a simple GST, one tax, minimum tax, simple tax. So, and we're already working on it. And we're pretty confident that we'll be able to significantly simplify it. Certainly take it down from five different levels to one main level and maybe a secondary level. But we are working on that and we are going to deliver that for you.
Thank you. The next question is from Professor Dorendra Singh.
Good morning.
He's in the first row. Please give him a mic.